Hey, happy Monday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. I got a huge update on what's going on in the Caribbean. First of all, happy Veterans Day to all my fellow veterans out there. God bless you and your families. Thank you so much for serving. Now, this is already at 40%. If you've never been here before, make sure you subscribe. I am all year long. My subscribers has been knowing about this over a week. I do early with the data. And I'm showing we still have all that convection still lasting all the way to the end of November and more chances in December. Now, what I'm showing is that not only do we have a chance for a rare hurricane coming in late November, a chance for a major hurricane right here, according to the Euro, according to the GFS as well. And it's going to be a dangerous situation because with the environment, it's going to swish around to the east, then it's going to come back to the west and go north around that high pressure. So it's also going to bring a lot of storms and a lot of chances for this to go towards Jamaica, the Western Caymans, Cuba, maybe even some of Yucatan, and go right towards Florida. Now, the trend has been that it's going to strengthen up on the deep ocean heat as it goes by the Western Caribbean, potentially becoming that major hurricane, everyone, but also weakening down somewhat to a Cat 2, maybe even a high-end Cat 1 as it goes towards Florida. That's the latest information. So make sure you click that bell, follow along with the updates. That way you know what to expect out of this system and stay updated what's coming after this. Because like I said in my last few videos, hurricane season is not over. Now the latest from National Hurricane Center, you can see they have it where it's going to slowly start moving westward. This is going to move westward, then it's going to go eastward, and then when it comes back west, it's going to go north. This is where you have that elongated high pressure just suppressing everything down. But soon that high pressure is going to move over here, allowing everything to come to the north. You can see this when you check chances for a tropical depression. So as you go 4 and 5 days, this is where it starts bottling up over here by Nicaragua, Honduras. And as you see, it goes towards the east as you get that cold front and that trough comes out, pulls it a little bit, then it goes back and bottles up and heads back to the north. And remember, while it's sitting over here, potentially by Jamaica, there's deep ocean heat for it to tap into to help it strengthen up. And as it goes towards the Western Caribbean later, there's deep ocean heat right here for this storm to tap into and strengthen up. And what I can see in the pattern is that we're going to have a trough coming in, but it's going to be way over here, and we're going to have a high ridge. So that's going to allow that to meander right over that deep ocean heat when it does head north. As you can see in the ensembles, we are at 4 days, showing it will finally start to strengthen up towards a tropical depression and quickly go to a tropical storm. Now watch how it starts swishing a little bit to the east, and almost all the members agree that that trough is going to push everything over while this high pressure expands over towards its next destination. Then when it transfers over, it all goes back to the west. But in the beginning part, it also shows a good chance for a strong tropical storm to a potential hurricane passing right by Jamaica as it goes on that eastern push, then that western push. So you can see the latest information here. This is the 19th. This is right when we're about to get that big blast of cold air on the 20th, like I showed you in the previous video. And look at this. You have the high ridge, so nothing is blocking it. You have your high pressure moved over here, and now it can steer everything going to that north push. And you can see this is with the Euro, and this right here is a major hurricane, everyone. Look with the GFS. Exact same spot, exact same scenario. Even the icon sees it right there as well. I will show you. So you can see in the atmosphere how we get here. You see as we begin in, you see that precipitation goes across to the Western Caribbean. Then we get that first trough on the 15th. Remember that 15th and the 20th. 15th comes down. It tries to pull out a little bit of precipitation, but mostly just blocks that from doing anything. Upper level high rolls across the Gulf from the west side to the east side. And this is where it sways from the east back to the west. You see that? This is the Euro, showing right around the 20th. And I'm showing also this could go further to the north or even into this direction before turning. You can see the same thing with the GFS. So as you watch it, it goes to the Western Caribbean and meanders back to the east from that first cold front, the first trough right here, bringing some precipitation off of that system. That right there would be the best chance to weaken some of it down before it tries to strengthen back up. Then it goes back to the west on the same scenario that you see the euro on. Both of those are almost on in an agreement. And the euro has shown that that will build up to where it be a major hurricane, everyone. Gets it all the way down to a 955 millibar. 955 as it goes towards Florida, Cuba. Who knows where it goes at this point? It could sit there and stall a little more. It all depends. This is still 9 days down the road, so we still don't know what, even though it's trending a little bit, we still don't know what this is going to do, because they can both trend the changes together. So I will keep you updated. So when you go by the ensembles of the euro, you can see literally what they are all saying. As it goes on that eastward push, there is a couple that shows it could go out. It could go out with that first trough, get pulled away, and we're not even talking about a Gulf hurricane. But however, the majority shows that it will stay in there and be in the Caribbean, get blocked by that high pressure, and then go back to the west. It could turn early. It could turn a little bit later. You can see this on the other members. Remember, Euro has 50 members. Shows it builds up, goes back to the east a little bit. And like I said, this could be some serious impacts on Jamaica, because if that forms up, look at this, that would bring the winds and the rainfall on Jamaica and potentially be there for quite some time, because it's going to do like a stall effect and sit there. Then it's going to get pushed back to the west. But look at this, you got the one here. This is what the icon is showing right here by northern Yucatan. That could go even further towards Georgia, a little bit closer towards Alabama, but a little bit more towards Georgia, a little bit more like what Helene went on. And you can see these as well. Showing on this one, this is the worst one of the north, showing it don't go back to the west. If it does go a little bit further north, still it's going to get blocked over here by Cuba and the Bahamas and still go back and do that little wiggle with the S. Look at the GFS. GFS shows that block, shows it going back. But look how it strengthens up with GFS, just like it strengthens up right there. Now, that right there brings it down to a Cat 2 hurricane, and right before landfall, weakened down a little bit more. So it does show that while we're getting that dash of cold air on the 20th, bringing a major snowstorm potentially with it. And you can see on the members of the GFS showing the same thing. You have something forming up right there in the Western Caribbean. You see that? Very strong from what I can see with the euro, and it can go right towards Florida or go right in the center. You see that one? This one shows it can go right in the center if it goes by the Yucatan, a little bit further to the north. Icon model showing the same thing, but showing it will go to that westward push by the 18th. And now look at this. Now you have the storm system coming in. This would pull this further to the north. This is almost one of your bad scenarios here, worse than we can see what's going towards Florida, because this storm would pull this to the north and it would impact further places more than just potentially Florida. So when we look at another icon, we go by the spire that goes by the satellites. It's showing the exact same thing that the euro is showing, a 950 something millibar major hurricane going towards Florida. Also showing when that cold air comes down, it's going to bring major snow. Matter of fact, when you look with the GFS, it's showing that not only is it going to bring major snow all the way towards the north central, we're going to get that second dip, and it could add up to even more snowfall coming with this snowstorm. You go by the previous run, it's still showing a big snowstorm right there for the central or north central. So we got to watch out for that part as well, because that's anywhere from 1 to 2 feet. Even though it's a lot of snow and everybody wants it with the nice cool temperatures, this would create a lot of problems. Now, that is the latest update. I will keep you updated every single day. Make sure you click that bell. Afternoon updates is going to start pretty soon, because we're about to get an invest shortly after a day or so. I'm sure we're going to see an invest here, and that's when I'm going to do afternoon updates. So make sure you click the bell and follow along. Now, before I go, Psalm 145, 1 through 6. I will extol thee, my God, O King, and I will bless thy name forever and ever. Every day will I bless thee, and I will praise thy name forever and ever. Great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised, and his greatness is unsearchable. One generation shall praise thy works to another, and shall declare thy mighty acts. I will speak of the glorious honor of thy majesty and of thy wondrous works, And men shall speak of the mighty of the terrible acts, and I will declare thy greatness. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. This is getting very concerning what we're starting to see on this pattern. I will keep you updated. Please help share this information, alert others, wake others up, let them know it is not over, everyone. I will see you again for tomorrow morning. Afternoon updates will start shortly. Remember, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. Sorry for the bad news.